在美国历史上，持枪权被认为是最重要的个人自由权利之一。1789年，由麦迪逊提出的宪法第一至第十条修正案，也就是《权利法案》中，人民持有武器的权利被列在言论、出版、集会、结社之后，成为第二条修正案的核心内容。截止到2012年年初，美国有7个州以及首都华盛顿对在公众场所持枪制定了极其严格的限制，其他的州则在不同程度上可以公开持枪，有些地方需要向政府申请，有些地方则不要。
We still lose 30,000 of our fellow citizens to gun violence every year. 30,000 die in gun murders, in gun suicides, and in accidental shootings.
谁在枪后面拿着这把枪，那么他的意志是去 control 这把枪了。那么他去拿着枪是杀人，当然不是枪的问题。
We have a federal government that has forgotten that it has only very limited assignments from we the people, and it's become rather abusive. Let's think about this. The last century, the 20th century, was the most murderous century in human history, and most of the murder was committed by governments against unarmed people. Government is the greatest murderer of all history. We avoided that. We cut that off before it could even get started because we had guns. And we've seen in our own country that where laws are more restrictive, crime is higher. Where people are in a position to carry firearms with them wherever they go, even concealed firearms, you find the crime rates either staying level or even going down. And so our experience has been with our different states and our different laws, that the easier we make it for people to be armed, the lower the violent crime rates are.
对于酝酿中的各种限枪法令，诺瓦军械的店员杰森认为，鉴于美国人拥有枪支的传统，限枪法令将会阻力重重。
It was part of our culture of firearm ownership, going all the way back to when the colonies were settled. We had a God-given right to have firearms to protect ourselves, to defend ourselves, to provide for ourselves, if we need to hunt. That's just a right that the Constitution recognizes. So it's a little more complicated than just saying you can't have any more guns. There's probably some politicians in this country that would like that, but I think overall it would not be very favorable. The reality is like this state, we issue a concealed carry permit, so you can get a permit so you can carry a firearm concealed in your waistband. Well, the Virginia permit is recognized by 33 different states. So there's only 50 states in this country. And in 43 of the states of this country, you can carry a concealed firearm. So the reality is the majority of the country believes in those rights the Constitution grants us.
弗吉尼亚州居民布莱恩则表示，用立法来限制枪支，并不能阻止想犯罪的人通过不正常的渠道获取枪支。
Folks who aren't obeying the rules and the laws can get weapons.And then the home, the person who's trying to follow the laws can't get a weapon based off of our rights being taken away. Not only unfair, but doesn't make sense.
这些年来 ，NRA 以及各种枪支爱好者的组织参与政治选举越来越深。在大大小小的各级选举中 ，NRA 都会给候选人寄去长长的一份调查问卷，详细的询问候选人对有关枪支立法的态度。同时，NRA 会给所有的现任议员打分，通知成员各个候选人在枪支问题上的态度。在很多选区，特别是在乡村和小城镇，受到 NRA 抵制的候选人往往很难获胜。从地方到总统选举，第二条修正案永远是最受关注的竞选议题之一。
民主党一向是比较反枪的，共和党对枪好像柔和一点。他们比较那个保守一点，觉得自己是可以拥有枪支的。
NRA 支持的候选人中有共和党，也有民主党。即便是主张更多的限制持枪权的人，也不会主张从根本上废除宪法第二条修正案。
There's got to be some way that we can balance the constitutional rights of hunters and target shooters and collectors and everybody who wants to and really appreciates being a gun owner with the safety of people who are just out Christmas shopping. I think that the likelihood of any kind of federal legislation passing is very limited, although after the Virginia Tech massacre, there was a lot of concern in the Congress to try to tighten the rules so that if somebody had been involuntarily committed to a mental health facility, as this man had been, that record would be there. The federal government doesn't want your guns. I don't want your guns, but I also don't want people who are going to use them to kill dozens of Americans in an unprovoked way to have access to guns. We ought to be smart enough to figure that out, and that's what I'm going to try to do working with people.
权力法案的起草者乔治·梅森曾经说过，奴役人民最好、最有效的方法就是解除他们的武装。这句话很好地诠释了美国人民对自由不懈追求的决心，以及对专制的警惕。这句名言到今天仍然被大多数美国人所信奉，有理由相信，围绕持枪权的辩论在美国还会持续下去。但是，权力法案为美式民主打下的基础坚如固鼎，恒远如磐。